One thing you'll be required to do in this class is back up what you say by citing credible sources. In fact, a lot of your college experience from here on out will involve the citation of supporting sources. To ensure the credibility of sources, it's best to go a step beyond the standard Google search engine. One way to do this is to go to Google's special news feature. By default, Google News gives you the top hits of the day, the news that most people are reading. However, as with the standard Google search engine, you could type in your own custom searches. Let's say we're interested in researching floods. News results will appear from a variety of sources, local, national, and international. Let's go ahead and open one of these articles. Now, assuming there's something in this article that backs up what I want to say, or even better, something I've learned from this article that I want to cite, I'm going to want to give the article credit. For example, this article claims that dumping waste materials during construction into rivers is raising the riverbeds, which make them flood more easily in the future. Perhaps I want to quote this line in the paper I'm writing. If so, I'll probably want to put it in quotation marks. After all, these aren't my words, and I want to give credit to the person who the actual words belong to. But also, if I'm quoting the words of a respected source, like Reuters News, it gives my argument more credibility. Now, I need to collect certain information here. For example, what's the name of the article? Well, at the very top of the page, you see it has a name. So that's a good thing to keep track of right there. We also need to know, when was the article written? That information is usually pretty close to the title. We also need to know the name of the news agency. This information is generally at the top of the page, but it's also generally part of the URL. It's also helpful to know who wrote the article. This information too is generally near the title, often right next to the date. And since this is a text-centered class, we're going to want to know what the URL is. This information, of course, is in the URL bar. Now, of course, we have to find a way of organizing all this information. The name of the article, the date, the name of the news agency, the name of the writer, and the URL. There are many standard ways of citing this information, but the documentation style that we're going to use is CSE. CSE stands for the Council of Science Editors. So not surprisingly, when you look through engineering works, you'll see things cited according to CSE style. The first source they cite is listed as number 1, the second as number 2, the third is 3, the fourth is 4, and the fifth is 5. Not surprisingly, at the end of the work, the references are listed in order of appearance. So the number 1 we saw up here in the introduction of the paper refers to the number 1 here in the references. The works here aren't alphabetized, but again simply listed in order of appearance. Medical articles use a similar format. The first source cited is listed as 1, the second one is 2, etc. And at the end of the paper in the references section, the sources are listed in order of appearance, not alphabetized, for example. So as you can see, B comes before H, but that doesn't matter, because this article was cited before this article. If you look at popular online encyclopedias, you'll see the same thing. The first source cited has a 1 listed next to it, the second source cited has a 2 listed next to it, and at the end of the article, they're listed in order of appearance, regardless of alphabetical order. So how do we transfer this information into CSE format? Well, first we take the author's family name and pair that up with her first initial, and we place those at the beginning of the reference. Then we take the name of the article and put that as our second item. The news agency is our third item. The date is our fourth item. However, we'll want to list the date CSE style. CSE starts with the largest time unit first and ends with the smallest time unit. The largest is the year, the smallest is the day, and in between those goes the month. So instead of July 17th, 2013, we'll start with the largest unit, which is the year, 2013, and end with the smallest time unit, which is the day, the 17th. The month in CSE is abbreviated to the first three letters of the month. Even if the month name is only four letters long, you still always abbreviate it to the first three letters. Finally, we want to list the URL. In CSE, the URL is always followed by the words "available from," with a colon right afterwards. Since this is our first reference, and naturally thus our number one reference, we'll cite it simply by putting the number one in square brackets. And of course, we don't want to just drop a quote in the middle of a paper. So we'll probably want to introduce the quotation with something like, "According to one article." Properly citing your quotation serves a number of purposes. But among the most important is the fact that your readers can verify where you got the information from and check it for themselves. On the online CSE format guide, you'll see a sample paragraph followed by a cited references section. Since I'm citing this source first, it's called 1. Since I'm citing this source second, it's called 2. Since I'm citing this source third, it's called 3. Notice also that if I go back and cite source 1 a second time, it's still source 1. It doesn't become source 4 or source 5 or source 6. As long as all this information is the same both times I cite it, I could keep on repeating this one all throughout my paper. There's also an exhaustive list of pretty much every type of source I'll ask you to use in this class. For example, web page or online periodical when the author is known. Web page or online periodical when the author is unknown. Book, one author. Book, more than one author. Film or video recording. Online video. Electronic image. Song or recording. Overall, CSE is a very simple system, but more importantly, it's a web-friendly system, which is why so many online encyclopedias use it. It's important in academic writing that you give credit to the originators of the ideas you're talking about, and it's important that you do so in an academically approved style, like that of CSE. As always, if you have questions, feel free to email me at cadam@ucla.edu. Also remember that you can come see me during my physical office hours in Humanities 218. My office hours are listed on my syllabus. Thanks again for watching, and have a great day.